Movie Studio Zen. My name's Derek. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to prepare a project in Vegas Pro that you want to turn into a DVD or Blu-ray disc with menus. So this is basically how to render your project when you need it to send it to DVD Architect Pro to turn it into a snazzy little disc. So first thing I'm going to do is just import some test footage onto the timeline. Now, next step I always like to do is go into the project video properties box and make sure that my properties match exactly the same as my source video. So a quick way to do that is to just press the Match Media Video Settings button. Navigate all the way through your computer and find the same video you just imported. Select it. That'll set everything automatically for you. Then make sure your resolution quality is set to best. Go to the Audio tab and make sure the resample quality is also set to best. If you tick this box down the bottom and apply it, that'll lock in best for all time. Okay, so now you're going to spend a lot of time making a glorious project. Before you're ready to render it for DVD or Blu-ray, always remember to do a final save as. Now, in my case here, I haven't even named the project. So let's go to File, Save As. And you can see with Vegas Pro, it remembers where I last was. So you've got to be very careful when you do save projects that you're putting it into the correct folder. So I'm going to go up a few steps. And so, yeah, I'm in the right master folder. DVDs. So I'll create a new folder. And I'll just do a quick copy. Control C. Open it up. Control V for paste. Save. Okay, so how do we render for DVD? We'll do the DVD first. Go to File. Render as. And first thing I like to do is make sure the output folder address is set. Very common mistake people make is it forgetting to do this. So let's go to, should open up to my documents. Vegas Pro 13, DVDs. Here we go. So click save. So the output folder address has been set correctly. Let's tick all options here. That's better. So let's, for DVD, we use MPEG-2. So open that up. And now you need to use a little bit of brain power. So look at your project video properties. This will help you out greatly. So if your frame rate says 29.97, 30, or 60, you'll be using DVD Architect NTSC widescreen video stream. That's what you'll be rendering to. So we can actually make this a favorite, make it easier for next time. If your original video was 25 frames per second or 50 frames per second or even 100, you would be using DVD Architect PAL widescreen video stream. And the third option that you may be using is if this says 24 or 23.976, you would be using DVD Architect 24p NTSC widescreen video stream. So they're the three options that you would normally choose from. So for mine, I'll be using NTSC widescreen. So select that. Now, if you wanted to, you could press customize and do some further tweaking. However, these settings that are in here are already maxed out at the best options for making a DVD. So no point really mucking around in there. So all you need to do is press render. So let's do that. Okay, so my video has finished rendering. Now, one thing I forgot to mention, just in case you are a complete new user, whenever you make a DVD or Blu-ray disc, the video file and the audio file are always rendered separately. That's just the way it's done. So once we've finished rendering the video, we have to go back in to render as and do the audio file. So let's go file, render as, and there's a couple of options you can use, but probably the best one in Vegas Pro is to use the Dolby Digital AC3 Pro. Let's star that, and we don't need to change any settings, so just press render. So also remember, let me close that. Let me go back into render res for a second. When you do this, you must make sure that the audio file and the video file both live in the same folder and both have the exact same name. The only thing that's going to be different is the file extension, and the program will do that for you. So once you've done that, it's now ready to import into DVD Architect Pro. But just before I do that, I now want to show you how to render video if you want to turn it into a Blu-ray disc with menus. So if you want to do that, we'll go back into File, Render As. And for making Blu-ray discs, we actually have two options. You can render to a main concept MPEG-2 template, or you could also render to a Sony AVC template. And they're clearly marked here, Blu-ray. I like to use the MPEG-2 templates because they support a higher bitrate. So we'll go down here, and there are all our options. The best quality one is the full 1920x1080, and just as I said previously about the different frame rates, make sure you select the right run. So for 29.97, that is equal to 60i. So let's star that. Actually, these three here are the three best ones to look at. But there's only one choice here, and that's 60i. So select that. Don't need to customize it. So, there is one thing I forgot to mention. I better go back one step. Now, I forgot to talk about adding chapter points. So you can add chapter points for DVDs and Blu-ray discs while you're still in Vegas Pro, which is very handy. So to do that, let's go back here. You press M on the keyboard, M for Mickey Mouse, and that creates a chapter point. Okay, now I'll go back into Render As. Go back to my main concept MPEG-2, find the Blu-ray templates, and there's only one option, 60i. Now if I scroll down that window further, we have an important thing to select. Save project markers in rendered video media file. You must remember to do that, otherwise the chapter points won't be rendered with the file. Select render, and when that's finished, I'll then tell you about what type of audio file to render for your Blu-ray disc. Okay, the video for my Blu-ray has finished rendering, so I'll close that. Now we've got to do the audio, so go back into file, render as, close that back up. And the best option for audio for Blu-rays is to use Sony Wave 64. Let's scroll that down and let's use a 48,000 Hertz option. You can see there's quite a few there. I think the best one there is 48,000 24-bit stereo PCM. So let's star that. select that, and select render. Done. So now we're finished. All the rendering's finished for our DVD or Blu-ray disc. So at this stage, I always like to do a final save as. Just a habit I've got into. Yes. And now we can actually close Vegas Pro up. So let's open up DVD Architect Pro 6. Okay, so just in case you are a new user of DVD Architect Pro, I'll give you a little tip. Go to Options, Preferences, Preview, and make sure aspect ratio has been set to 16:9, which means widescreen. Okay? Okay, so first thing we better do is actually start the project and set the project properties correctly. So I'm going to go File, New, and let's do the DVD first. So the video I made in Vegas Pro was using NTSC settings, which is 720x480-60i. That's the one there. So let's select that. And I also rendered to AC3 stereo, which is Dolby Digital. And now if we want to go a little bit further, oops, it's an old project. We can name stuff in here if you like, but it's not that important. So click OK. Now we can import the video from Vegas Pro. So the best way to do that, the superior method, is to right click on top of the disk tree here, untitled, select Insert Media. Now we need to find our Vegas Pro projects folder. And there's the folder I created. And here are all our files. So we've got two sets of files in here. One set are the ones I made for DVD creation, and the second set are the ones for making a Blu-ray disc. So the DVD one will be .mpg. So select that, and let's make this a bit bigger, and drag it onto the menu. Now I'm not going to go any further with talking about how to use DVD Architect Pro 6. Just wanted to show you how to render the video and how to get it into DVD Architect. That's the way you do it. So that's how you do a DVD. And you don't have to worry about the audio because the program automatically captures it for you because you named it exactly the same. I suppose one final thing we should do is remember to save the project. So let's do save as, and it's remembered where I last was. So let's go back to the master folder, DVD Architect Pro 6. The first thing I really should do is create a new folder for this project. So let's create a new folder, and what will we call this? DVD with menu test one, that sounds good. And I'm going to highlight it all, Control C for copy. And where did that go? Here we go. Double click it, highlight, Control V, paste, save. So that's safely saved. So I'm going to close this up now. Now I'm going to show you how to set for the Blu-ray. So we'll set the project properties again. So let's go back into File, New, Menu Based. This time I want to select Blu-ray Disc. And now there's even more options. It's crazy. So we've got to make sure we select the exact same one we used in Vegas Pro. So MPEG-2 1920x1080-60i. Now, if you are in Europe, Britain, Australia, parts of Asia, you probably would be selecting 50i. But I used NTSC settings, which is the North American format, so I'm going to select 60i. And this time I actually didn't use Dolby Digital. I used the WAVE format, which means I'll have to select PCM Stereo. And once again, we can fill this out if we want. I'm going to leave it blank. Click OK. And this time, this has gone quite large because it's a Blu-ray disc. So it's 1920 by 1080. So to see more of the screen, let's just reduce it. Final step, import the Blu-ray video. So let's right-click on Untitled, Insert Media, and it's remembered the last folder I was in. And this time, we're looking for .m2v. There's my video file. Double-click. There we go. Drag it onto the menu, and Bob's your uncle. Once again, the program will automatically captures the audio file for us. Now, to confirm that, we can just go into preview, press this, and I can hear the audio quite fine. Final thing, once again, remember to save your project, create a special new folder. So you can see there, it's remembered that last project I just made. So I want to go up one step, create a new folder, Blu-ray with menus. Let's call it test two, that'll do. I'm going to highlight it all, Control C for copy. Find where it went, double click, Control V to paste, save, and now it is safely saved. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to teach you and give you a little bit of a very good tip on is how to actually burn your DVD or Blu-ray disc once you're in DVD Architect Pro 6. Now, just to recap, I'm not going to be talking about how to do menus in this tutorial. That's a different one. So, when you're ready to burn the disc, final thing to always do is to do a final save as. So, file, save as. Yep. Yes. And okay, make Blu-ray disc. So I'm gonna, the workflow for DVD and Blu-ray is the same from now on. Two options, prepare or burn. Prepare just prepares a file that can be burnt later. I wanna do it, the preparing and burning in one go, so I do the second option, burn. Two options here, current project or previously prepared project. So if you did have a previous project, you'd select that, find it, by doing browse, and then you can burn that. But I'm doing this for the first time, so I select the top option, current project. So here is my first big tip. DVD Architect Pro does a very strange thing in my opinion. So if we click on top of here, the output folder address for where the disk file is going to live, they've got it sitting here. So we've got documents, DVD Architect Pro 6 projects, there, that makes all sense. Then it jumps to my disks, then the name of my project. Now that's silly. I want everything to be living in the master project folder for this Blu-ray with menus test 2. So it's all around the wrong way. So what I do every time is click browse, go up one, and you can see here where DVD Architect Pro has automatically created this folder. We don't want it there. We want it in my main project folder here. So all I do is I grab it gently and drop it into there. Open it up, select my disks, because that's where it wants to put the disk files. Click save. Okay, that's going to work out much better. So do that every time. Next, sometimes you might have to deal with some stuff here. Next. And here's my second tip. So in DVD Architect Pro, many times you may find that volume name is grayed out and you can't change it. So the volume name, what that data is for, data, is in some Blu-ray players, when you pop the disc in, it might, a little message with the LEDs may come up, and that's where you can set it right here, but it's grayed out. So how do you fix that? Well, this is what you do. You actually have to get out of here, so let's cancel. Where you can actually set it is go to File, Properties, scroll all the way down, and here it is here. So if we want to call this the blah blah volume, and oh, by the way, you're only allowed, you have a very strict sets of characters you can use, and they're all uppercase. So we're going to do blah blah volume 1, click apply, okay. Now let's go back to make Blu-ray disc, follow the same pathway, and I'll have to go and change this again because DVD Architect keeps doing that silly thing. Select the folder in there, save, next, next, and there we go. And the very, very final thing, this is something you'll have to experiment with, is there is a wide range of different types of DVDs and Blu-ray discs that you can burn to. Some are better quality than others. And I know a lot of users have been telling me that quite often, once you put your disc in, and say if it says it can do a fast burn speed, that it may actually be better to slow down the burning speed. That'll give you a much more accurate burn. Some of these high-speed burns end up creating errors. So that's something you'll have to experiment with. So that's it. Click Finish. It'll render the whole project. It'll tell you what's doing on the screen. And then it will finally burn the disc. And you're done. So that's it. Hope that helps out, everyone. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Ciao.